Hey guys, how's it going? It's Target here. Welcome back to another player build where we recreate a real NHL player as they appear in NHL 14 for your use in EASHL. Today is an attainable player. It's been a while since we've done one. We did two of my custom guys that I use on a normal basis, but we're back at it. We're doing another one that's been requested steadily over the last little while by a number of people. It's another power forward. And it's big Brent Burns from the San Jose Sharks. EA dropped his overall recently with that last update post-trade deadline. And so he was a little bit more attainable as a power forward. So now we can actually do him quite easily. And we're going to pop in here. And I'm going to show you the attributes and the hockey shop. For height and weight, you want him 6'5", 220 pounds to make it realistic. If you really want to be able to hit a lot, probably drop his height down 6'4", 210. All right? Because we're going to have to see how this goes. So, Brent Burns, Deking, I put it up at 87 because we had the X. Oh, wait, we'll do the hockey shot first. Sorry. Plus 7 wrist shot power, plus 7 wrist shot accuracy, and plus 7 offense awareness. We'll then do plus 7 speed, plus 5 speed, and plus 7 acceleration. Finally, plus 7 balance, plus 7 agility, plus 7 body checking, and plus 7 passing, 7 strength, and 7 puck control, okay? Alright, so Deking 87, that's a little bit higher. I had extra points so I could do it. Hand eye at 83, offensive awareness at 87, passing 84, puck control 87. I had an extra one to put in slap shot, wrist shot accuracy 85, and wrist shot power at 88. Defensive side, aggressiveness at 87. Normally I don't put aggressiveness in, but you know what? We're actually going to do it for this guy because we had extra to spend. Body checking at 86, it's not that high, but you should still be able to crush people. Defensive awareness at 84, discipline at 80, fighting skill at 69, and then stick checking at 84. Another good number. He's a good defensive build for sure. Athleticism, acceleration 87, agility 84, balance 82, not as high as it could be, durability only 71, endurance 83, speed 89, and strength 90. The reason why I copped out on balance is because it's not important, and durability, your guy's big enough where you're not going to get hit down anyway, so you should be okay. Alright, now a lot of you really enjoyed that I showed you guys exactly how he played, so what I'm going to do is do another little game here and see how he plays. I'll give you my review of him, and then you guys can make it a judgment for yourself. I'll show you his highlights, and I will see you guys shortly with that. Alright guys, welcome back. So the game is complete. We won the game 5-3. I'll show you the stats first off. So 5-3 with a goal. Shots were only 16-11. Hits 44-16, and you can guarantee most of those hits were me. Time on attack, we got outpossessed, but you know what? It didn't matter. We won the game. I'll show you the scouting first here before we get into anything. So, 2 goals, 3 assists for 5 points with this big right winger, Brent Burns. And I'll tell you what, I thought it was going to be bad. But for drop-in games, this build is so much fun. I thought his speed and his height and weight would be a big problem. But he's a bone crusher. Brent Burns murders people. Let me show you here. So, yeah, 5 points. 21 hits in this game, guys. And a lot of them were huge hits. Look at the first period. Starting with the very first hit of the game was me on McLeod. Look at this. Hit him so hard, I knocked the net off. Look at this. Boom. Absolutely crushed him. Then I got a hit not too long after that. So, this is the second hit of the period. So 2 hits right there. So, that's number 2. Boom. Number 3 against on Jackson. That's a bad view. Here you go. Number 3. Just crushed him. Number 4. Boom. Took the puck away. Number 5 on McLeod. Another huge hit. Number 6 on this dude. Just took the legs out. Number 7 on Jackson. Huge hit. And number 8. 8 huge hits in the first period. All right. 8 huge hits. Second period was... I always find the second period very quiet for hitting. But this is number 9. Boom. Number 9 of the game. Number 1 of the period. Number 10 of the game, number 2 of the period, another huge hit. Number 3 of the period, and 11 of the game, so it's 11. So I only got 3 hits in that period for 11 hits total. All right, 11 big hits. And then we go to the third period, and I got a few more. Here's one on Hoder. Boom, just crushed him there. So that's 12. Here's 13. 14. And 15. Just erase. Look at this. Helicopter spin, man. Hit him so hard, he spun around. He's a beast at hitting, guys. If you look at goals, though, I'll show you the goals and how they went down. So I actually scored 2 goals. And here's the first one. I made this pass. That was the last one here. So here's the first goal that I scored. He feeds me right in front, and I managed to just tuck it like that. Just outweighed him. But if you look here, I actually got an assist on this. Look at this move. You can't see it as well, but you can see that I did a toe drag. Or drop to the skate shot. You can see how I'm in the middle of it. Drop to the skate, deke, and then tucked it around, put it to him, and he was able to clear it by. The next one was scored by me. He manages to find me an open space. I just outweight the goalie and tuck it short side. And then right after that, a breakaway goal, semi-breakaway. I kind of lose the puck. I regain it with that insane puck control he has. And I'm able to tuck that right beside the goalie just like that. All right. And then Johnson, I believe, got an assist on this. I just outweighted him, put it right on his stick, and he tucked it. Top Chad beauty play. Look at this. Just cycle around, weighted, and put it right on his stick. The next one, a same thing. Look at this. Toe drag right across. Protect the puck. Back. Across, and then there's a nice little shot there. So this guy is very doable in a game. Probably more fun for dropping just because you get so many hits. So enjoy, guys. Let me know what you think down below in the comments section. Also, don't forget to suggest who you think I should use in the next one. Also, don't forget to vote for the Be a GM vote. The link's down in the description below. Okay? So until next time, I'm Target Audience, and I'll catch you guys out on the ice.